Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollo Tech, and today Apple released iOS 13.1 Developer Beta 4. Now this is also out for public beta testers, and you should be able to find it using Software Update as long as you're using the beta program and have the beta profile installed. Now, I wasn't able to use that method to get this update on my iPhone XS Max for some reason. Unfortunately, I had to use iTunes, and I'm not really sure why this happened, but no matter what I did, either removing the beta profile or rebooting or anything like that, reinstalling the beta profile, I wasn't able to update. I had to use the IPSW file from Apple and install it via iTunes, and it was about 4.2 gigabytes, so it's a pretty significant file. I updated the phone. I didn't have to wipe it, but I updated the phone and it was finally installed. So hopefully this doesn't happen in the future, but for some reason that happened to me. Now, also, if you're concerned about going to iOS 13, the public release that comes out tomorrow, you won't be able to do that without using iTunes and downgrading. Now, I've made a separate video on how to do that. I'll link it in the description so you can downgrade if you want to. It's a pretty simple process, but you do basically have to wipe your phone or install it via an IPSW on Windows or Mac using iTunes. Now let's take a look at the build number, what's new, performance, battery life, and then we'll take a look at the Geekbench scores. The build number is 17A5844A, and this particular build hopefully gets us ready for the iPhone 11 launch on Friday or 2 days from now for the iPhone 11, the iPhone 11 Pro, and the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And hopefully we'll be able to install this beta, iOS 13.1 Beta 4, and then restore from a backup of a device that's running the same beta. So hopefully we'll have that ready to go so that we can have an easy way to restore. Now, this particular update is not very big, but it does have a few resolved issues as well as 27 known issues. So right now there's still a bunch of known issues, mostly for developers, but there are little glitches here and there, such as trying to use Chromecast, for example. They still haven't fixed that, and that's true on any of these devices. And as you can see here, I have the iPhone SE and iPad Air 2. But on the iPhone XS Max that I have here, it's running okay so far. We'll talk about more of that in just a moment. But there's also three resolved issues, and these are fairly significant because I know they bugged a lot of people. And the first resolved issue that they fixed has to do with music and playback stopping in the background. So many people were complaining about music just stopping in the background when they were playing it. Maybe they'd open something else and it would stop. This should fix that problem. So that's pretty significant. And then also the three-finger gesture that was driving everyone nuts. When you go into an area like notes, you can tap three fingers and get a new dialogue at the top with some cut and copy and paste. Well, that would show up in different applications. So they've actually offered two fixes. They've fixed that issue. When you're not using an application where there's a text dialogue, that will no longer show up. So unless there's a text input field and you use three fingers, it won't do anything. Also, they've given app developers the ability to override that three-finger gesture within the app themselves. So if it's PUBG, for example, where a lot of you were having issues, they can override that gesture and you won't have that issue anymore. So that should be fixed when it's released to the public on the 30th as well. For anyone playing on the iPad, that should make it much better. Now in this update, there are no new modem updates, and I have continued to have an issue when I drop off of Wi-Fi and go on to a cellular network. I haven't had that issue so far with this beta, but we'll have to see after a few days. As far as features are concerned, I have not found anything new. I've looked across all my devices here, the iPhone SE. I've not found anything new significantly or insignificant. There's just nothing really here. I thought maybe under notifications, there were some different size fonts, nothing really there. And then if we go to general and fonts, again, it just says open app store. So we don't have a ton here yet. There are no new fonts really yet, except for maybe this one. There's some storyline fonts. And on the iPad Air 2, nothing really new there as well. So nothing exciting, nothing new, but hopefully stability fixes and background fixes. As far as performance so far, it's been pretty good. 3D touch is about the same. It feels about the same speed when I 3D touch on everything from music to photos or anything like that. And overall, it's good there as far as performance. Performance on older devices seem to be good so far on the SE after using it for about an hour or so. You'll see scrolling is good. We'll load music for the first time. We'll give it just a second here. Go back to browse. You'll see scrolling is nice and smooth, which is really nice to have it this fast on an older device. And then also on the older iPad Air, the same thing is true. There's no performance issues whatsoever. So it seems to be good. And then even on the older devices, we've got that 3D touch or haptic touch on all of the different app icons. So you can rearrange or share it or have the haptic touch options. Now, as far as battery is concerned, well, Beta 3 was actually pretty good. I got some great battery life the other day. If I go down to battery, we'll give it just a second here. And you'll see over the last 10 days, I had great battery life. You'll see my screen on time was 5 hours and 54 minutes and screen off time was 1 hour and 18 minutes. That was with about maybe 5 or 10% battery life left. So it's doing okay. Like I said in the past, about 6 to 6.5 hours. Now performance overall, like I said, is good, but let's take a look at the Geekbench. Now I am running Geekbench 4 and Geekbench 5. So I thought we'd take a look at both since we're going to switch over to Geekbench 5. You can see under Geekbench 4, we'll look at that first. We have a single core of 4,803 and a multi-core of 11,443. This is quite good on an iPhone XS Max. If we take a look at the history, you can see that it's quite good. It's much higher than last time by almost 1,000 on multi-core. So it's a little bit lower by about 20 on single core, but 1,000 higher on multi-core. So we should have pretty good performance overall. Now, as far as Geekbench 5, let me show you for reference on this device because Geekbench 5 is a little bit different. Its scores are going to be a lot lower. So you'll see 1,116 for single core, 2,446 for multi-core. So much lower with Geekbench 5. I'm not sure why they did that, but they're resetting everything. Now let's take a look at all three devices. Now on the left, I have the iPad Air 2. In the middle, I have the iPhone SE, and on the right, I have the iPhone XS Max. This is all Geekbench 4, and you'll see we're about 1823 on the iPad Air, 2575 on the SE, and 4803 on the XS Max. You'll see the multi-core scores are 4459, 4533, and 11,443. Under Geekbench 5, these scores are drastically different, 382, 560, and 1,116. For multi-core, 1,059, 1,031, and 2,446. So again, a huge difference when you're using different versions of Geekbench. Now expect iOS 13 to release to the public tomorrow. It still has a lot of bugs. I would stay on 13.1 if you're already on 13.1. It's a much more stable update. So that's it for iOS 13.1 Beta 4. Let me know what you think in the comments below. There's a few small fixes, not really any major changes, but that's what we expect this late in the beta stage for iOS 13.1, since it's going to release on September 30th. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.